Hello and welcome to another edition of Lab Rats. My name's Andy Walker.
I'm Sean Carruthers.
And this is the show where we demystify technology. We take all those weird terms and we make it simple and you'll understand, you'll feel more geeky, and your grandmother will love you more.
100% guaranteed.
Guaranteed. If you watch all of our episodes, you will become more geeky and better, and your grandma will give you bigger kisses.
Absolutely. If you want them.
That's right. And who doesn't, really? Today on the show, we are going to show you how to build the ultimate computer. The ultimate computer. The computer that you will be able to brag to your friends and say, I have the best computer on the planet.
Something that's like the size of a house at 600 teraflops.
Teraflops. Something like that, yeah. No, today. So as you know, recently I decided to acquire an Apple computer, a MacBook Pro, because I finally gave into the propaganda, right? I had my Steve tattooed to my left back buttock. And so now I have a physical machine. However, I'm not going to live my life without Windows. Windows has to exist in my world. And so Sean showed me how to put Windows 7 on my Mac and have both, best of both worlds, which is really the best computer in the world.
Yes.
Today, we're going to show you how to do it.
Yes.
And you're going to say, you're going to agree with me the whole episode?
No.
Right.
See, I'm a man of many words.
Yes, you are. Let's take a break. When we come back, Windows 7 on a Mac, the best computer ever. Today on?
Yes.
Lab Rats. Well, welcome back to Lab Rats. Before we get on with the show about the best computer in the world, I want to remind you about Harvard.com, the best place to register your web domains, like
my computer's the best computer in the whole world.com.
There you go. Or
my computer's the best computer in the whole world.tv.
So get on over to Harvard.com. We're going to give you 10% off with this fantastic coupon below my beautiful little face here so that you can get the your domain super cheap. And now, on with the show.
Yeah, don't try to register my computer's the best computer in the whole world.net because that's already taken.
That's right. Yeah. It's your blog, isn't it?
I just registered it.
I knew it. I knew you did. All right. Today on the show, we're going to put Windows 7, of course, best Microsoft operating system ever, on a Mac, which is almost sacrilege. It's almost sacrilege. Look, see?
See?
Just like that.
Right? Just like that.
We're going to install it. Thank you very much, Mr. Carruthers. And you know what? It's an amazing experience. I, for the longest time, and I agree, I resisted Apple's. I really did. Now, I have to say, the hardware, this device is fantastic. Except it kind of cuts your hands when you put your hands on here. But otherwise,
what a wussy.
It's a great, it doesn't have a backspace key, but you know, it's a great computer. Really, it is. I really enjoy it. But I wonder what put Windows on it. So, Sean, you're going to show me the best way to do this. Now, we can do it a couple different ways, right?
We can do it a few different ways, yeah. So there's a, virtualization, I think, is the way that a lot of people are going to do this. So now you can run it in virtualization mode, which basically means you're creating a fake version of Windows as a machine. So it's like you're running a Windows notebook, but it's all done in software.
It's almost like running Windows 7 in a window.
Yeah, it's in a window. Right. So you're still running Mac, but Windows is running inside that. Right. So that's virtual.
Right. You can, and why would I do this? Like, what would be the reason for me to put Windows 7 in a window on a Mac?
Well, maybe you need to run Mac and you need to run Windows at the same time.
Maybe I love Windows 7.
Maybe you love Windows 7 so much you can't stand not to look at it even while you're using your Mac.
Correct.
So that's one thing you can do. Yeah. So there's a couple ways we can do that, and we'll get into that in a second. The other way you can do it is just load it in something called Bootcamp. So Bootcamp is a tool that allows you to carve out a section of your hard drive on the Mac, set it aside to run Windows, and then it gives you the option when you're loading up and you hit the right key of going to Mac or going into Windows. So you can run one or the other.
Right. So I mean, you may want to choose to, so you're going to do your Mac stuff, you're going to play with some pixels and be all happy about it, go to the Mac. You want to play, you know, gaming, you have all kinds of Windows games, you're a big PC gamer, right? You know, you go to Windows 7. Perhaps that you want to play with viruses, you're going to go to Windows 7, right? That's just a Sean joke. That's a Sean, and I'm just going to give you that.
You're starting to turn into me. You got the computer, you got
I know, it's awful.
So,
but before we go on with the techie stuff, though, what are the other reasons why we'd want Windows 7?
Well, a lot of software, it runs only in Windows 7. So let's just say that you work for a particular company, you've got an asset management system that absolutely will not run on Mac because it was only written for Windows. So now you can run it on Windows, either in virtualization mode or natively, depending on how you need to do it.
Right, exactly.
So there's a ton of things that can only work in Windows.
Well, yeah, and like me, you know, you're tenuously going to let go of Windows. You don't want to completely commit to the Mac. Yeah. Or perhaps, you know, if you're going to be a switcher, you know, this is a little lifeboat, which is Windows 7. You're used to that world. You play with the Mac a bit, you know, the Mac OS, and then you flip back on what it is. I've been actually installing all of my old apps. I've got a whole experience going on inside of Windows 7 on the Mac, and it makes me feel a little bit better, you know, instead of abandoning it completely.
Yeah, well, my mom had a Mac for a little bit. She ultimately decided it wasn't for her just because she doesn't like the idea of restarting two different machines. We didn't set her up with Boot Camp because she didn't have a Mac that could run it. But she always wanted to go back to the programs she was used to on her PC, and fair enough. This is what she was used to. She wanted to play those particular games on that. So, yeah, you can run those particular games in virtualization mode if you really, really want to.
Good. That's one reason. So many reasons why you want to do
this. Stuff you don't want to leave behind.
Right, exactly. Good. So let's now step forward. So you're talking about two partitions, right?
Yeah.
So you can boot into one or boot into the other.
Right.
It's not ideal, right? Because you don't want to have a complete experience inside of Windows 7. You want to easily flip back. And if you use Boot Camp, you're stuck in one or the other, right?
Yeah. So there's pros and cons to having a separate partition and booting straight into Windows when you want to do that. So the pro is when you boot into Windows, it's there. It's nothing but Windows. You don't have Mac getting in the way of your resources. So when you use virtualization, you run them both at the same time. Some of it's dedicated to Mac, some of that's dedicated to Windows. When you boot straight into Windows using Boot Camp, then basically all of your RAM is dedicated to Windows. All of your CPU power is dedicated to Windows. And there's no special virtualization tweaks that you have to do to make it understand. So when you connect a USB thing, like a USB webcam, through Windows when it's running in boot or in virtualization mode, then it has to translate that and go through to the other machine. Mm-hmm. And sometimes things that you connect to it don't work. So attachments, external devices may not work 100% in virtualization mode. So you may have to boot into Boot Camp, run Windows natively.
But that's not the advice you gave me, right? I mean, so Boot Camp, it's built into Apple. Mm-hmm. You said, okay, partition it. This is what I did.
Yeah.
Okay. But then you said, go get a piece of software called Parallels.
Mm-hmm.
So explain that.
So this is the third way of dealing with it. So you can run in virtualization, which Parallels is. Parallels Workstation or Parallels Desktop is a virtualization mode where you can run not just Windows 7, but other versions of Windows as well. You can run Ubuntu. You can run other operating systems. You can load them in and just run them in a window, like you were talking about earlier.
So actually, I could do not only Windows 7. I could put Ubuntu there. I could put any other operating system that I could put old versions of Windows. And, you know,
exactly. So you could run Windows 95, Windows 98, 2000, all of those. Yeah. Say you're a developer, a software developer, and you want to make sure that your software is going to run on all of these. You can have them all ready to load up at a moment's notice.
Got it.
Another version that you can run is VMware Fusion. We've got a version of that here. It's
so you don't have to use Parallels.
You don't have to use Parallels. This is another way that you can do it. So.
Right.
There's a few others as well. These are the two I've tried. VMware Fusion, some people swear by it. Some people swear by Parallels. I tend to go back and forth depending on my mood.
Right.
I've got Parallels installed at the moment.
All right. So let's go through the process by which you showed me how to do this, right?
Okay.
So I booted up my Mac.
Yeah. So the third way that we were talking about is, first of all, you want to start by putting Windows into a Boot Camp partition so that you have the option of booting into it. Now, with Parallels, you can actually say, you know, run virtualization from that partition.
Ah.
So when you set up virtualization in Parallels for the first time, it'll install onto your Mac partition and create a virtual hard disk, a big file, basically like 30, 40, 50, whatever size of gigabytes, just dedicated to that on your Mac, right?
Mm-hmm.
If you put it into a separate partition, it basically installs Windows onto that and doesn't put it on your Mac drive, right? But you can point to the other drive and load it up from there so that you have access to it no matter what you do.
Okay, got it.
Okay, yeah. Does that make sense?
It does make sense, yeah.
Okay, so the first thing you need to do
if
you're getting started for the very first time is you have to load in the Boot Camp utility on the Mac. So you can
How do you find that?
You can click on Spotlight at the top right.
Or Command Spacebar.
Or Command Spacebar.
Which I love,
by the way. You're learning.
I am.
So, and you start typing Boot. It's a utility, but it's called the Boot Camp Assistant. So you click on that.
Boot space camp space assistant.
Yeah,
there it is.
And you can also get to that by going to the Finder and clicking on Applications and then the Utilities folder.
Okay. So what it'll Finder is like Windows Explorer.
Right. Mm-hmm. So
see, I'm learning. I'm learning.
You're learning. Okay. You're not going to need Windows 7 for much longer.
Apparently not.
All right. So what it'll do is it'll fire up a little introduction as to what this is going to do.
Yeah.
Right. And you type continue or hit the Continue button.
Yeah.
And say create or remove a Windows partition. And the first time you do this, you'll leave it on create or remove and hit continue. And Right now, it's going to give you the option of turning it into one gigantic partition because you've already got one.
Don't want to do that.
But what it will do for you if you don't have one set up yet is it'll give you a slider that allows you to move your bar across to say, how much do I want dedicated to the Windows partition? How much do I want Mac to be?
This is the Pi slicer. You have a hard drive. You're going to be slicing the Pi into chunks to where you're going to do
right.
Which so, operating system is going to go where?
Yeah, so it'll give you two chunks. So you slide it over as much as you need. I'd recommend probably at least 30 gigabytes, maybe 50 if you've got a big drive. So as much as you can comfortably spare from the Mac partition. Uh-huh. Right? And then you would click continue to, and then it'll start carving that out.
Right.
Okay. So I'm going to go back because I don't want to remove my partition here.
Right.
So once you have done that is you want to go into Parallels.
Yeah.
And
Then don't you actually then install Windows 7 to that partition?
Yeah, you can do that through Bootcamp Assistant. So right. It will take you through the partition, and then it'll take you, you're right, it'll take you through the install of Windows onto that. So
right.
All the way through.
Okay, good.
So once it's installed on there, then you'll come back to the Mac side of things. There's a tweak we need to show you first, because this will leave you in a very perilous state, potentially, if you're unfamiliar with the Mac.
Right.
Or you're not 100% sure of these little tweaks. So once you install Windows for the first time on that Bootcamp partition, the next time you restart, it'll take you straight into Windows.
Yeah, that's what happened with me. Like I restart my Mac, and all of a sudden there's Windows, and I'm like, oh, did I install over the Mac OS?
Yeah, no, it happened to me too, and it's one of those little things that just bugs me because it just assumes that Windows is what you want to do for the rest of your life now just because you happen to install on your machine. I'm not sure whether that's a Microsoft thing or whether that's part of Parallels or what. Mm-hmm. But you want to set that back to the Mac potentially, unless you're happy with it being going straight to Windows. So restart your machine, hold down Alt Option as you're rebooting until it fires up, and it'll give you a list of operating systems that you can choose from. One of them will be Mac, one of them will be Windows.
So let me just reiterate that, though. So you hold the Alt Option button down, and you touch the power button, and you hold that key down until it comes up and it'll give you options.
Yeah, if you do it quickly, you can just press the power button and then hold Alt Option down.
Right.
Right? And then it'll
give
you the
options. It
took
me a couple tries, actually,
yeah.
To figure that out.
It's a little tricky sometimes. If you don't hit it fast enough, it'll just boot straight into whatever you have as the default. So now, choose Mac.
Choose the Mac.
Choose a Mac, boot into it. Go up into your Apple menu once it's all booted up. Go to System Preferences. Uh-huh. And then over to Startup Disk, which is down under the System panel. And now this is going to be set to Windows at the moment. So I've got Mac OS, and I've got Windows, and I've got the network startup. If you have a disk installed or in your drive, it'll give that as an option as well. What you want to do is you want to click on Mac OS here, and then close the dialog box, so like so. And then every time you log in, now it'll default straight to your Mac OS. But you can go to Windows anytime. So if you're going to go into Windows via bootcamp mode and load it natively, you'll just hold down Option on Startup.
Right.
And go over to Windows and then boot up that way.
Okay.
All right?
Very good.
Are you with me so far?
I am with you so far.
Okay. So now you install a program called Parallels Desktop mm-hmm. on your machine. Mm-hmm. And VMware is much the same way. You set it up in the same sort of way. Install the program. Now you'll go over to New under the File menu, and you'll say Operating System Detection. It's a new virtual machine. So you're going to set up a new virtual machine on there. Mm-hmm. And you have two options here. Now, if you were just doing this virtualization mode, you didn't plan to carve out the Bootcamp Assistant, so skip that step. Don't run Bootcamp Assistant. Don't install Windows that way. But instead, you would put the Windows CD in here and leave it on Installation CD DVD and then whatever drive your thing is. If you're running it on a notebook like this, it'll just be the one drive. And then click Continue, and it'll install Windows that way.
Yeah.
But since you've already installed Windows on your Bootcamp partition,
right.
Instead you would click on Bootcamp partition and then click Continue.
Right.
And then that will link up to the installation of Windows you've already done.
So now Parallels is wired into the Bootcamp partition that has Windows 7 on it.
Right.
And you can do virtualization easily.
Yes.
And I guess the advantage of this is that the data is separated. Mm-hmm. Right on the hard disk itself, mm-hmm. and it just keeps. Like, what's the fundamental reason behind this?
Well, there's a couple reasons. One of them is, like you said, it is separated. It isn't one gigantic file. If that one file gets corrupted, then you could be in for a world of troubles. If you're doing this straight in virtualization mode, mm-hmm. and now it's kept as separate files on a separate partition. Now that's not going to save you if the drive goes bad. If the drive goes bad, it'll take down both partitions.
Right.
But it also, like I said, it gives you the option of booting into one or the other. So if you boot straight into Boot Camp on Windows native mode, it will be faster. You'll have all your resources.
Right.
But you still have the option of using that same install to run Windows in virtualization mode without creating another 30 gigabyte partition on your Mac side as well.
Got it. Yeah. Okay. Good. So. Good stuff. All right. Well, let's take a break. I want to show you some kind of cool features of how Parallel works after the break, because there's some interesting ways of actually running Windows applications on top of the Mac OS without actually being in Windows, which is kind of cool. So we'll take a break and see that after this. All right. Sean, I think at this point now, let's show off the product, because I think there's been a lot of talky, and we've shown them, but really, you know, the magic here is in the actual playing with this thing.
Getting it running, right.
It's awesome.
Yeah.
So what do you want me to do?
Okay, so the first thing you need to do is you have, when you launch Parallels, after you've set this all up, you'll have a little dock that shows you, you know, your various options for setting up. So you'll press on the one that you want to go to,
right?
And then that'll fire up. It'll say, click here to start this virtual machine, because it may be suspended, so click through, and it'll launch. It'll take a little bit of time to get going. We've got ours running here. So now the magic is, now I've got Windows running here, and I've also got the Mac in the background, as you can see.
Right.
And you know, if you want to drag files from one to the other, you can just grab one.
That
from
was
one.
Really clever, as far as I was concerned. Like the idea of being able to move files easily between two windows. Right. You basically have two computers running.
Mm-hmm.
Right. It was just really clever.
Yeah. So if you have a program that you need to use in Windows, but you want to access to the final result in Mac, you can just do it up in Windows and then move it over. Now, the first time you do this, it'll give you this dialog box that says, do you want to enable access to Mac OS X files and folders from Windows?
Do you?
The answer is no.
Why not?
No. If you do that, it'll be easier. It'll just allow you to see both from both all the time.
Right.
The problem is then if you actually have a virus on your Windows side of the equation, which has been known to happen, then potentially you can just reach over and grab stuff from the Mac.
Yeah.
You maybe don't want to do that.
Right.
Now, if you say no, that doesn't mean it's not going to copy this file. It will still copy the file. You'll just have to do it manually. So basically you're saying only send things across that firewall when I say so. All right? So that's one thing that you can do. And you can drag it in both directions. So I can now drag this back over to my Mac side of the equation as well.
Okay.
So, and it'll give me that again. So don't show this message again, say no. Okay?
Okay.
So now you notice that we have this running in a window right here on my Mac. And there's a few different ways you can do this. So you can view it in this window mode as you have here. You can do it in full screen. And what that's going to do is it's going to do a little bit of rejigging here. And now it looks basically more or less like Windows 7. Mm-hmm. So I've entered full screen mode to exit full screen. Use Alt, Command, and Return.
Mm-hmm.
So remember that so you can get out of this. So you go down, start menus here. I don't see my Mac stuff. It's still running in the background, but you're not dealing with it. So close this, and we're going to hit Alt, Command, Return, because we want to show you something else. Alt, Command, Return, and that will take us back into our regular mode.
Mm-hmm. Okay, good. Now, there's something called Coherence Mode, and I was really impressed with this.
Mm-hmm.
So tell me what that is. How does that work?
Coherence Mode is a slightly different mode that is actually kind of cool. First of all, the full screen mode is actually a godsend to anyone that is running a separate monitor. So you can actually run full screen Windows in one monitor, full screen Mac in the other, as opposed to just running one or the other. So if you go into coherence mode, what it's going to do, again, it's going to take a couple seconds to think. It's going to have it so that both Mac and Windows are running at the same time. Every time you do this, you'll get this special message telling you what's what here. So makes your Windows integrated with the Mac, and your Start menu and your Windows applications are now available through the dock. So then you can just do everything you do from Windows in that way. So not necessarily the most easy to use. It's not natural for someone using Windows, but now anything that you open up in the Windows side of things will show up in a Windows menu, and you'll have the Windows menu, the Windows Windows, and the Mac Windows running side by side in their virtual modes.
Right. All right, so there's another feature called Crystal Mode. What's that?
So what Crystal Mode is it's kind of like Coherence Mode. So it gives you access to your Mac and all of that. But it also, as you can see, it gets rid of Parallels as running in here and just puts a little icon at the very top of your screen in your system tray.
So it hides all the Parallels controls and stuff.
Right. So then you can get to it by going up to the top and getting to it from that way and using your controls there.
And so we have to do picture time because we're running out of time here. But one final thought, you had an issue around, there was a tip around activation, Windows activation.
Yeah, so we set you up with Boot Camp and Parallels so that you could boot into either. Now, because it's running in virtualization mode when you're running in Parallels or VMware, to be fair, it is using a different configuration than it would as if it was in actual native mode. It's looking at different hardware. So it sets up virtual hardware for your machine to run in, which is obviously not the same as your actual hardware.
It's like creating a new computer on the fly every time.
Yeah, they're two separate computers, really. Yeah. And when you boot from one to the other, well, you know what happens if you switch too much hardware inside your Windows machine. Microsoft doesn't like that so much, and they say, you need to reactivate now.
Yeah.
And it's different enough from one to the other that it will do that when you go back and forth.
You can find out with an invalidated Windows 7 install.
You find yourself without an invalid, right. With an invalid. So you probably don't want to go over to boot camp unless you absolutely have to once you've set this up. Mm-hmm. And just keep running in Parallels mode. But
right.
Do it if you have to. And generally, a nice person at the other end of the phone of Microsoft, if you do have to activate and you've activated too many times, they're pretty good about reactivating you. It's just a pain in the butt is what it is.
Got it. So. Okay, great. All right. Let's move on to pictures because my favorite part of the show, as always.
Yes. So, first up, we have our friend Gregory Hammond.
Yes.
Who is in Ajax. He's a longtime fan of the show.
Yeah.
So, Ajax, Ontario.
Gregory.
And Gregory wanted to let us know that he has a site, gregoryhammond.ca.
Nice. And hope he registered at hover.com.
We hope so. Yeah. If not, right. He could.
Very good. All right. Well, thanks for hanging out with us today. It's really kind of a cool technology. I hope that those of you that do have MacBooks, can you run this on MacBooks as well as MacBook Pros?
Of course.
More or less,
as long as it has an Intel processor in it.
Right.
So anything that's old, that's worth mentioning. Anything that's really old, may not running.
Good stuff. Well, I hope you'll try out our tricks. It's an awesome way. I mean, I am really in love with this machine. And the fact that I have access to Windows and also the Mac OS is an amazing experience for me. So if you want to send us pictures you can, or comments or letters, you can email too.
You can run Ubuntu too if you set up a virtual machine for that in Parallels at labrats.tv.
Or more simply,
feedback at labrats.tv.
Right, we'll include your letters in a future episode or pictures as well. And finally, I want to mention Doc Callahan, of course, one of our tutorial makers here at butterscotch.com has an amazing tutorial on VMware.
Yes.
There's a couple of tips and tricks and that
sort of
thing.
Yeah, he noticed there was the problem getting your things running well connected through virtualization as well. So he's got some troubleshooting tips there.
Oh, that's good. A good geek tutorial for you there. So anyway, that's it for us. Thanks for tuning in this week and pushing play. We'd be foolish to be here with our MacBook Pro if you weren't out there with your Windows 7. My name is Andy Walker.
I'm John Carruthers.
And we'll see you next time.
Are you ready?
All right, so we're all rolling. Your screen grab's rolling.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, good.
Thanks,
oops, mine wasn't rolling. You're telling me to do all these.
There's our food
partner. Bingo.